If elected, National's promising to crack down further on gangs by enforcing tougher sentences. Leader Christopher Luxon calling the closing of schools in Opotiki in the last week unacceptable when hundreds of gang members poured into the Bay of Plenty town for the wake of a mongrel mob leader killed just days earlier. That's despite some accusing Luxon of using the tangi as a political football. According to the latest police data, there are almost 8,900 gang members spread across 33 different gangs in New Zealand. And Luxon says if you align yourself with a criminal gang, you will face more severe consequences. This coming after National has already said it plans to ban gang patches in public places. Political editor Jessica Much-Mackay joins us live shortly with more on the party's latest gang announcement. But first, here's her report.
Gang tensions have been front and centre in Opotiki over the last week. School closures and buses diverted to make allowances for the tangi of a gang leader.
This is unacceptable. Why should other New Zealanders be inconvenienced and fearful because gangs are allowed to run amok in this country?
So National's tailoring its policy announcements to fit. The leader unveiling in Auckland today he'll change the law so judges have to take gang membership into consideration when dishing out sentences.
What evidence have you got that putting gang members in jail for longer works?
What I have is an evidence that I want New Zealanders to feel safe in their businesses, in their homes and in their communities, and they don't. And we saw that last week.
But those who work on the ground with gang members say tougher sentences won't work.
That's only going to increase the level of hatred and the level of harm that we're really seeing.
It's pretty classic dog whistle stuff that happens every 3 years.
I'm not politicising it at all. I've been talking about restoring law and order since I became the leader 18 months ago. And this is a reality. This is not politicising it.
The police minister says it's lazy politics because judges can already use gang membership as an aggravating factor in sentencing if they want.
Christopher Luxon has embarrassed himself by making a gangs announcement that is already law.
National's already announced it wants to ban gang patches in public. Gang member turned councillor Warwick Godfrey had gang insignia tattooed on his face until recently.
Banning of gang patches is pretty pointless, you know, when you've got it on your face.
It's a condemning and persecutive policy that drives negative narratives against people. But actually, all they are requiring is love.
National says gang numbers have gone up by 3,500, showing what the government's doing isn't working.
There's no doubt about it that the arrival of 501s back into New Zealand has added a layer of complexity to the criminal networks we've never seen before. But that's why we're going harder on gangs.
And I make no apology for putting victims first and getting tougher on gangs.
Tougher on gangs is a phrase we're sure to hear a lot of as the election campaign heats up.
Well, political editor Jessica Much-Mackay joins us now. Jess, will National's proposed crackdown on gangs resonate with voters?
Gangs are always a hot political issue and they're particularly timely and poignant at the moment. National are being opportunistic here. They're trying to strike while the iron's hot, and politically that definitely makes sense. But when you dig into this policy, it's really only changing a word or two in the law, and it is an option that is already available to the judiciary at the moment. What this policy announcement does do, though, is allow National to yet again talk about the government being soft on crime. We heard Christopher Luxon say that message several times today, and he'll be hoping that some of that is getting cut through. National is also arguing that this is just a small part of a wider sentencing policy that will be announced soon. The government's response to that is its new legislation that it just brought into law around giving police more power for search and surveillance around gang members, things like seizing guns, for example, worked really well in Opotiki. It really is, though, the only silver lining out of all of this. The gang issue has been a big headache for the government over the last week, and with tomorrow bringing in a new political week, you can be sure the government will be wanting to talk about almost anything else.